Talking to Brandon Krause right here, a very, very good trainer. He has a lot of pro fighters in his gym. How many pros you got now that you train? Four or five? That's badass, Brandon. I remember you just had amateurs. How does it feel to be a professional boxing trainer?
I'm trying my hardest, man.
What's it like? Walk us through like the weigh-in day. So you come, you sign in paperwork, right, first?
Yeah, you gotta check in with the commission.
Mm-hmm.
You know, your...
They check your IDs?
Yeah, you have a fighter has a federal ID. They check to see if I'm licensed as a coach to work the corner. Then it's a whole lot of hurry up and wait. They are doing a lot of paperwork with the commission is doing a lot of paperwork with the promoter, and hopefully in somewhat of a timely manner. Not always. They start calling you up, and then your fighter who is a zombie by that point, trying to make weight, finally gets to get on that scale. And the only thing that they care about is that goodie bag that they have been sitting next to for that whole day.
With the Pedialyte and the Gatorade and the water.
Pedialyte, the coconut water, and like some cookies or something like that.
And then from there, usually they whisk you away and they take you to a place where you choose the fight gloves. Walk me through that, picking the fight gloves and your opponent fight gloves.
So I'm not of that level yet where it's like that.
That's more championship fights?
Yeah, for me, either my fighter brings their own gloves, and in California, you got to bring two gloves because you got to bring gloves for you and your opponent.
But the commission holds on to them.
And the commission holds on to them. They got to be brand new, and they got to be in the package and all that type of stuff.
Yeah, I don't want people to think that you pick two pairs from your gym.
No.
No, they're brand new pairs.
They have to be brand new
in the sealed
package. Yeah.
And the commission take it. But you get to open them before you give them to the commission and try them on. Not even?
No, we always have to give them to the commission.
Okay.
So you can open them.
You have a fighter with 15 fights. I thought he'd be at that level yet. 15.
You can like bring our own gloves, correct. Yes.
But they're sealed.
They're sealed, yeah.
And
yeah.
The commission inspects them and signs them off. And the
it's
opponent.
Not like, for me at least, it's not like what you've seen with a Floyd fight where he goes to this table with five pair of gloves and he tries them. I wish, you know what I mean?
You'll get there.
Yeah, I'll get, I will. But
Gervonta did that with Leon. Leo signed off on the gloves. He had one pair of winning, one pair of grand.
Yeah.
And most fans at home don't know how it works, Brandon. So they watched Tank in the locker room warming up with Grant, but then fighting and winning. And the winning that he had no logo, because a lot of people don't want winning to put anything on the glove. They're not here to do a free commercial for winning. So I've seen it a lot where they...
Well, but or a fighter will have a sponsorship from a certain company, and they wear an opposite gloves. And as to avoid a conflict of interest, they'll have no insignia
yes,
on the glove.
That's
yes.
true. So what happened...
I remember Ricky Hatton, who was sponsored by Lonsdale, fighting in Everlast gloves, but putting the Lonsdale thing over the
Interesting.
Everlast.
Interesting. Nobody got mad? But what I'm saying is, so everybody was like, Tank, change gloves. But I have the video where both Leo and the commission sign off on these gloves and approve them.
Glovegate.
Yes, but there was no Glovegate. It was fake news. And after I released the video...
It was a Russian disinformation campaign.
And after I released the video, Brandon, no one said anything. Because they didn't know how it works. Now, hearing from you, they'll hear how it works. So, when do you see the gloves? On fight night in the locker room when you show up to the fight?
If we don't bring our own gloves, fight night, the promoter will have gloves for us.
The promoter.
Yeah.
But again, they're sealed. The commission holds on to them. Not the promoter. The promoter won't give you gloves. The commission give you the gloves.
The promoter has the gloves. The commissioner will take the promoter's gloves and give them to us.
And then you have a commissioner that's inspecting, along with someone from the other team, they inspect the hand wraps the whole time.
You have that option, but I haven't had ever the other team watch me wrap.
Did you ever go watch the other team?
I did. I have had a couple of my... In the beginning, I don't really do it. If I'm in California, I don't do it because...
They're straight.
The commission is solid. But yeah, if I'm like in Mexico or some shit like that...
You want to make sure they're not putting plaster parrot in.
Yeah.
And then, once the glove's on... They'll tape it up, and the commission will put the initial CA or TEX or NV.
Well, first they need to do that with the hand wraps. So they inspect the hand wraps, and they put
lines back and forth.
Yeah,
so you don't add.
So you don't add or adulterate it in some way, so they can tell exactly, right? And then they'll put the gloves on. And in California, they will tape the gloves, but in other states, you have to tape your own gloves, which is odd.
But then,
California also uses that slick kind of tape that's either red or blue.
Yeah, same in Texas.
But other states will just put like white.
And that's what falls off during fights. And you say, time out, the tape's wet.
Sure, and that's what gives you abrasions too.
Yeah.
Like, you don't want that shit to slide across
it
your
cuts
face.
Your cuts, scratches.
Yeah.
And that's it, that's fight night. And then after the fight, what happens to the gloves? After the fight. Fight's over.
I mean, they are, if you buy the gloves, they're your property, you can take them. If they're the promoter's gloves, they're the promoter's property. He's not going to want you to take them. Some promoters are so big that they just don't really care if you take them or not.
There was a commission guy in New York that every extra pair, you know, you have two pairs, would end up on eBay. And there was an eBay page with every guy that ever fought at the Barclays Center. Now it's not there anymore. Someone said, hey, what? But someone within the commission was taking those gloves and selling them.
You Kid know, Chocolate. Because somebody obviously wasn't that, wanting yeah. them back. You know
yeah,
what I mean?
So they took advantage. But there was no glove gate.
No, there was no glove gate for that fight.
No, and Tank, actually, Robert Garcia told me that winning is more padded than Grant's, so it was better for Leo that he was wearing winning as a brand.
Didn't seem to turn out to be the case.
No, because Tank hits, his name is Tank, and he is punches are like missiles. I invited you to the gym to have one of your guys spar him.
We have sparred Tank.
What do you remember from that sparring session? I always bring you to spar Mayweather, to spar Tank.
You do, thank you, Ellie.
What do you remember from that spar? It was also one of those short notices. Brandon, you want to come to the gym and spar Tank today?
Oh, my guy had been, Matthias Radcliffe. He had been training all day long. And
that opportunity came
and
along.
He had personals to do. And yeah, he made the choice that champions do. He chose to challenge himself.
And tell me about the sparring session. It was a Goosen gym.
It was a tremendous learning experience for my young charge, Matthias Radcliffe. And we saw really the worth of Gervonta Tank Davis.
He's the real deal. A lot of people weren't believers, Brandon. They had to see this performance to believe in him. You already knew it because you saw it firsthand. Yeah. I've been telling people for 6 years, this kid is special.
But this was that kind of fight. You know, he did need to. If he wanted to be of the level of clout that I think he envisioned.
Pay per view star. Yep.
He needed this, and
he got it.
And he did it. Correct.
He took punches. He gave because if he comes in and knocks out Leo in one punch, I hate now that people before pick Leo to win. You know what their answer is now when I see them in gyms. Ellie, Tank fought a smaller guy. You weren't telling me that 2 weeks ago. You said Tank will be exposed. Power's overrated for boxers. Leo has the skill. Leo will overwhelm him. Now Leo's too small. No, don't change your story now that Tank beat him.
Call that Monday morning quarterback.
Just like everybody who picked Loma. Oh, Loma was injured. No, Teofimo outboxed him regardless. Injury, no injury. Teofimo did his best and won. Don't take away from Teofimo the credit.
No, nobody enters the ring 100%.
It's true, even Teofimo just had foot surgery. But I wish Loma all the best. I hope he comes back. I wish Teofimo the best. Maybe they have a rematch. Maybe they each move on to different things. Do you think Loma stays at 35 or goes down to 30?
I think he'll only stay at 35 for a rematch with Lopez, and if not, he'll go back down to 30.
Now, a lot of people are comparing Gervonta Davis to Mike Tyson. I started that 5 years ago. Do you see it?
Not other than that they're both somewhat shorter, thick guys for the weight class with tremendous punches. But no, I don't think they fight anything alike.
Who does Tank remind you of then? Speed, power, explosiveness?
I think he's all of his own.
There you have it, Brandon Krause. You can follow my coach Brandon Krause on Instagram. FaceLoserPoint.com and my Segback reporting. You can follow me on Twitter @Segback. You can follow me on Instagram @EllieSegback.